Today I'm going to teach about body language. Body language is a very common thing that is accepted to all of us. We do have, whenever we speak with our body language. We do not stand at a very stiff position to speak. We always use our hands in a proper position to stand. We move our head. So all these things are very important part of body language. While we are communicating, we always pay attention to our body language. Now, body language is very, very important. Why is body language important? Because we see that body language, whenever we are communicating, automatically there is gestures and postures that happen. So when it is happening, whenever we are communicating, we have the gestures and postures it is very simultaneously that happens. We do not stand in a very attention position, or we do not stand in a very rigid position when we are speaking. It is told that body language is very important, and whenever you communicate, even if we are not speaking, we communicate with them. We see that body language is very important, because while communicating, we use our hands, our head movements. These are known as gesture. And the way we are standing, the way we are sitting, the way we are folding our hands, the way we are moving our whole body also gives out a particular message. So it's very important that whenever we are communicating, we pay attention to our the non-verbal aspects of communication, and because that is a important part of communication. Introduction. I'd like to give an introduction that communication, man does not communicate only through words alone. They do not communicate only through words alone, except writing, speaking, listening do play an important role in communication. Now, when we are communicating, communication does not have writing, speaking, and listening. But one major aspect of communication is the way we use our body language is the gesture. But non-verbal communication plays a major role. Now, we have different types of non-verbal communication. What is non-verbal communication? Communication where we do not use words. We are not using any type of words, neither spoken words, neither written words, neither any type of words. It is like completely blank. No communication. But still, without words, we are communicating, that is through hands, through nodding our head. If sometimes when we are called in the morning, we just nod our head, or like if attendance is taken in the class, we just put our hand up. So these are non-verbal communication. We don't need to speak, but still we are giving an answer, but still we are communicating. So there are different ways and different types of communication, different gestures that we have in our daily life. Like even in the planes, we see that they do not, when we come, they just give a namaste. So they don't tell you namaste, but the sign itself has a gesture that they are welcoming the passengers on board. So these all are non-verbal aspects of communication. Scientifically, we have analyzed that there's a research that has been done on non-verbal communication or the body language, which tells that verbal communication is 7%, voice and tone is 38%, but the main is the body language and gestures. The body language and gestures are very, very important, because maximum of the time when we communicate, our body language, the language that is automatically coming, gives a very, very important role to it. So that automatically comes. Like you don't, while speaking, while we listen to the national anthem, we do not make any gesture. Or we do not make, we have a particular posture of standing in an attention position. So that comes normally to us. Even if we are relaxing, we try to put our hand at the back of our hand and we sit and relax. So those all come normally. Nobody teaches us. Like we have a small infant, he or she is not able to communicate. And how does he communicate? Through like non-verbal things. Clapping his hand is showing that he's happy. Just giving a smile, showing that he is happy. So even his gestures and postures are also giving out a particular type of communication. So it is, this body language is not restricted to only one section of people, but we see that body language is there for each and every section of people, be it human beings, be it animals. This body language is a very normal thing that we take into being when we are communicating with people. Non-verbal communication needs serious consideration. Communication is incomplete without non-verbal effect. Now you have that non-verbal communication, you need to take it seriously, because the way we are standing, suppose we are standing with the hands on the hips, so it is giving you a very adamant type of communication. You cannot stand that in that position when you are talking to in a general meeting, or you are shaking your hands. When you shake your hands firmly, you are shaking your hand, means you are there with your client, or it's a professionalism that is shown. But in the same thing, when you welcome your friends, you have a different type of body language. Either you hug them or them give them high five. So it's a very different one. So we need to take that in a serious manner. We cannot just leave it, or we just cannot neglect it, because each and every way our hands are moving, our facial expressions, even facial expression is a part of non-verbal communication. So even facial expression, the way we give, the way we move our hand, the way we show our face, the way we smile, so all these are giving our impact. It is like, it is as if it is telling something out to the common man, or it is telling something to the receiver. Like in modern days, different types of social apps, we see that there is emojis. Emojis are what? It is general facial expression, or the different types of body language symbols are there. So we come to understand that how, for a feeling, for an emotion, we put that emoji. So for that, one particular body language becomes very, very important. So we have non-verbal communication has a lot of lot of different parts. One is body language, gesture and posture, the way we stand. Now, gestures are the movement of our hand and head. When we are speaking, we generally tend to move our hands and heads. Like when you explain something, when a teacher is explaining something, they are moving the hand and head together. Now, besides where the gestures are mainly followed by the people, those who can't hear. Like the deaf and the dumb people, they have a particular sign language. When they are speaking with other people, they have this gesture. They do different type of gestures for different type of what they want to communicate. So that is gesture. And posture is the way you are standing. Suppose you are bunking your class and you get caught by the principal. What happens? You don't look straight into the eyes of the principal. In fact, what you do, you either put your head down and stand as if you are ashamed of getting scolded in front of the whole class. Or if you know the answer, you confidently stand up and answer. So those things are a part of your posture, the way you are standing. Suppose you are sitting in a class in a very clumsy way, putting a hand on the cheeks and sitting. So it tells that you are daydreaming. You are not in a position. You are not paying complete attention to the class. Next, we have facial expression. Now, what is facial expression? The expression that comes on our face. We all know that face is like a mirror of what is there in our heart. So someday we are sad, that expression comes. Someday we are happy, we see that type of expression. So when we are very joy, full of joy, we have that expression. So everything is there on our face. So our face is like a mirror of our heart. Whatever is in our mind, whatever is going in our mind, whatever is going in our heart, it reflects. Suppose you did not have a good night's sleep. You are like your eyes are fully like reddish. So you feel that anybody is going to understand that you did not have a good night's sleep and you are feeling very clumsy. So that is your facial expression. You are happy, full of joy, your eyes are sparkling. So it tells that you are very, very happy. So face also gives certain type of non-verbal communication. Next we have color and design. Now color and design is what type of clothes we wear, what type of color we wear. Like in India, we see that the whole of India is being divided, and color plays an important role. Like for a marriage party, you see like people wearing loud colors. Loud means bright colors, a lot of jewelry. So they don't need to communicate that they are going for a particular occasion. So they can tell you, of course, through your dress that they are going for a particular festival or a particular celebration. People wear white clothes is either a celebration. People wear white clothes if there is a mourning or a condolence, or when if there is a holy festival also people wear white. But in condolence, when there is condolence meeting, then we see people wearing white clothes. So that is the time when we see that even colors are having a part of non-verbal communication. And you see, the four parts of India is having the colors are having different type of significance. They do not have the same significance. Where people of the north and the western region, they are full of colorful people, like, and colorful in their way they dress, the way they use their clothes. It's very colorful. But while you see that in the south and even in the east, people wear white clothes, like white sari or a white and golden sari, white and red sari for a particular function. So that is also a different, the occasion, they are also celebrating festival, but it is completely different because the occasion is because people prefer different color according to their own states. So that is how colors are important. Space and time, voice and pitch, and graphs and charts. So we have graphs and chart is also a part of normal communication, of verbal, non-verbal communication, because we see that suppose you are giving a presentation, you have to show an annual presentation where you have to show that 10 years what development you have done. You cannot speak the development, but if you picturize it through graphs, so you will see that it is very easy for the people, it is very easy for the people to understand. So they are only in pictures, but they will speak a volumes about what you want to explain, or your progress of 10 years is very, very easy to understand. So that is how it is shown. Kinesics, very specifically, if we want to study kinesics, what is kinesics? The kinesics in which certain body movements and gestures serves as a part of communication is termed as kinesics. And this is theoretically based. If you want to write a theoretical answer, you have to write like, what is kinesics? It's the study of certain body movements and gestures as a part of communication. Kinesics was introduced in 1952 by Bert Wintel. His study included how gestures and posture played a role in communication. First, communication was just written and spoken, but slowly people started observing. People started doing research. Now, when people started doing research, people started doing and see, and they also started communicating. They came to know that it is not only just words that are used for communication. In primitive time, we see that there were drawings, there were images. People used to draw images and they used to try to tell a story. So that was also a part of communication. So slowly they came to know that the way we are speaking, the way we are standing, the way we are sitting, all these are very, very important. It plays an important role. And now we see that corporate world is having a lot of like soft skill training, the way how you are going to give a presentation, what will your body language, how you are going to dress up. So this is also part of a training session, because Nowadays, these are also playing a very, very important role. So that is why kinesics has become a very important part of our daily life, or the way you even you communicate. If you communicate to the friends also, your kinesics plays a very important role. Suppose every day in the morning you go and you give a big high five to your friends, and one day you are not giving the high five, people are going to question you that why such type of body, why such type of sad gesture. So they of course have a type of so you are communicating with them without even speaking a single word. He argued that all body movement have specific message to convey. He's telling that everything is having a specific message which has to be, which is to be conveyed. You can convey it in a different way. So he tells that every part of every part of your body language is important. The way we use our hands are also important. The way we use our fist, the using of our fist, is a part of non-verbal communication. The using of fist has different types of meaning. The fist is a very small part of our body, but it can be used in various ways. So that is how the body language is playing an important role. Paul Ekman brought the concept of facial expression. Now, different people have started bringing in different types of communication. Like facial expression has been brought by Paul Ekman. Now, he's telling that even not only your body, but your facial expression should also have certain, they also express a certain communication, certain non-verbal communication to a particular person. So you should always know that our face is also communicating certain things. Importance of body language. Nancy Austin says that Nancy Austin is a person who tells that a person starts believing in non-verbal communication when he can't either believe his ears or eyes. Sometimes she's telling that non-verbal communication is used when people cannot believe his own eyes and ears, because you're not listening or you're not seeing. That time you use your body language. Psychologist Paul Ekman says we talk with our vocal cords, but we communicate with our facial expression, our tone, voice and our whole body. Even though we are speaking something, the way we are speaking, the way we are making our face, if I'm frowning, or if I'm happy, if I'm raising my eyebrows, everything has a communication. If you are having a conversation with your friends, suppose you're eating, your mouth is full, but you can't answer. So all of a sudden you don't agree with that person, and then you frown or you just raise your eyebrows in surprise. So the person will understand that you are having a query. You are not agreeing with that particular person. So we of course talk, but when we make a facial expression, the movement of a hand, body, everything becomes very, very important in communication. Understanding body language has an immense practical use. We should understand the body language, because nowadays body language has become very, very important. We have to make practical use of the body language. One careful observation, we can understand different people through body language. We tell that how will you understand the person? Suppose you are working with you've got an employment in our office. You need to understand people, because there are so many people. And how you are going to understand them? Through the body language, through their facial expression, through their gesture. If somebody is very warm, somebody is very cold, somebody is very arrogant. So everything comes, they don't need to speak to you every time. You can understand them through the body language. You just have to observe their body language. When we observe their body language minutely, that also plays a very, then body language has a different importance. You need to observe. In a class of students, when a teacher is teaching, a teacher can understand whether the student is paying attention in the class or he's daydreaming just with the use of body language. She or he doesn't need to go and ask personally, okay, are you paying attention in the class? No, that is not done. She can make it out from the behavior of the student, the way he's sitting, the way he's acting, the way he's his facial expression tells. All these are going to be conveyed through non-verbal communication. You don't need to ask certain questions. So body, you just have to observe the people, and when you observe the people, you of course automatically understand that this is a part of non-verbal, how body language is working. Facial expression, we all know that facial is the index to heart. It's a direct connection to our heart, and just as I've told you before, and with our face we communicate in so many ways. Whatever we feel deeply reflect in our face. We're having a bad day, it comes on your face. Though we have good proverbs in which we tell that we can hide through a smile 100 feeling, but still somewhere or the other our face only tells about what is deep inside us. This is important for face-to-face communication. Now, we tell that this is important for face-to-face communication because you need to see the face of the person. If you don't see the face of the person, you will not understand what the person is trying to communicate. But also in nowadays, you see that social media has made facial expression a part of, even though if the person is not in face-to-face, you can understand because you have those facial expression emojis that come up. So if you don't agree, if you're having a cold, if you are happy, if you want to if you are too happy, if you are blushing, if you are angry, if you are very angry, so all these facial expression comes through the emojis. So it becomes so that also has become a part of even though people are not in face-to-face, so that those faces are a part, and we love to put those emojis when we are communicating because we want to show how we feel at that particular moment. Every facial muscle is a instrument of communication. Eye contact is a essential part of facial expression. Now, eye contact, when we are nervous, we don't have the eye contact. We tend to look down or look aside. We don't look eye to eye. That time, it is very clearly understood that this person is not confident enough to speak to us. So, but the moment we have an eye to eye contact, we are having the eye contact with the audience or the person with whom we are speaking, the receiver understands that this person is very confident in speaking. But many times what we tell, suppose we are hiding something or we are telling a lie. Suppose you have gone out with your friends and your parents have caught you. So what do? You generally tend to hide your face. You don't have that eye contact. You generally tend to hide your face or look here and there, put your eye down, look down or look somewhere else when you are speaking with your parents. So that becomes how eyebrows are trying to communicate. There are some facial like normal facial communication are when we smile. A smile is of course a happy one. The time we blush, our cheeks go red. So we tell people tell, oh my god, you are blushing. So the cheeks go red. So that's a normal one, that the person is blushing in front. Then you frown. It tells that you are either angry, either you're not happy with the situation, or something is not going good with you. The moment I raise my eyebrow, I'm telling that I have a doubt. So please can you explain me once more? So that is the moment when I tell. When I'm moving my eyebrows up, of course my hand also moves. Like in this situation, what are you telling? So that is a part of non-verbal. The face is expressing everything. And of course, when we are making a facial expression, our hands automatically starts moving. Posture. Now, what posture is a old saying is there that hold your head high. When conveys a message, holding our head high. Like we tell that this is a proud moment, we hold our head high. Now, when you pass in your exam, of course, you are like in a very happy position. You're like jumping around and facing everyone. But if you have flunked in the subject, or if you're not passed in the subject, what you do, generally look down. You don't have that eye contact with the people, and you have that sad face, and you look down, or you look depressed. So that is how it conveys a message that your body language is also playing an important role. It is a sign of self-respect, confidence, and integrity. Posture always gives a sign of self-respect, confidence. If you are confident, it shows out through your body language. The moment I'm sitting and I'm just rubbing my hand, or I'm just twisting my fingers, so people come to know that I'm very, very nervous at a particular stage. So the confidence comes out through the body language only. Head jerking is a rejection. Like some postures, like I move my head, I tell no. I move my head, like when I'm moving my head up to down, it tells yes. When I'm moving my head right to left or left to right, it tells it's a no. So you don't need to speak out. You just give this gesture or yes or no. So it comes out automatically. There are some behavioral scientists who tells the shape of our body. Shape of our body have broadly put them in three types: thin, youthful, ectomorph, mesomorph, and endomorph. So the even our body shapes too have a type of body language. Now I answer the questions. What is the use of studying colors in the body language? Now colors in the body language, colors is a part of non-verbal communication. But when we are wearing different colors also, it is like giving an occasion. You come for to give a presentation. You are very specific. If you are wearing bangles, we become too conscious. You even our dresses, the thing we wear. Suppose you are going for a meeting, you don't wear too loud colors or neon colors. What you are going, but it also has a part of community. It also tells you something about the communication, what you are trying to communicate, or which occasion you are going to go. It's not directly related to body language, but it is related to non-verbal communication, because body language is of course a part of non-verbal communication. If you are wearing a particular blazer, or you are wearing a particular dress, and you are going out, it is giving you are communicating something without even telling out something. In some diseases, there is absence of expression. So how could body language help in it is just for facial expression, I don't know what type of disease are you talking about, but still there is a certain cases where you can use your expression, but even if your facial expression is not working, you can move your hand, you can move your head, and you can communicate. It is not always that even if your face is not working, if your facial expressions are not working, you can move your hands and hands to communicate with the people. Hands and your body language will of course speak. Now, effective use of body language. How you are going to effectively use your body language? Be careful with your handshake. Establish a good eye contact. You should always have a good eye contact and be careful. Now, there are different types of way you give a handshake. You give a firm handshake. You give it for a client. That is a very, very professional way. That is a different way. You establish eye contact. You know when you have to give an eye contact with what type of people. So communicate the level of the person before you. You have to communicate with that person in a particular way and you should know their level. Suppose you have the principal. You have the principal in front of you. You are so, and he's scolding you. So you not have a strong level of communication. You just look down. Communicate the level of the what we must be ourselves, graceful movements and confident posture to improve the environment of communication. So we see that it is very important that we have graceful movement. When we are in an office environment, we retain very professional way of communicating. We communicate in a professional way. So that should be very graceful. Even at times, we get too angry, but we don't show our anger because in our professional life, we have different type of people through whom we communicate. Now, these also have a major advantages and disadvantages. Easily visible aspect of communication. Advantage is that you communicate very, very easily. It is very easy for you, someone to understand what you are trying to communicate. It complements verbal communication. I cannot stand in attention position and just give a speech. That is going to be very, very monotonous. The way I am using my hands, I'm using certain action while I'm speaking, I'm using my facial expression, all these, what is going to happen? This will complement your non-verbal communication. This will complement your verbal communication. What you are speaking, it will be more effective. Has intensity in the process. It has a lot of intensity in the process of communication. When you are communicating with proper gestures and posture, and your proper non-verbal communication, it becomes very easy in the process to make things flow in a normal way. It improves overall effectiveness of the communication also. But at the same time, these have certain disadvantages also. You cannot rely on it completely. Sometimes when we are speaking to the people, those who don't have like the deaf and the dumb people, if we don't know all the gestures, it is very difficult for us to understand. For that, we need to do a special study. So it becomes very, very difficult for us. People of different culture and background have different body language. What body language the Indian people will have, the Korean and the Chinese people will not have the same body language. So it is very, very difficult to understand. So what happens over there? There's a chance of misunderstanding and misinterpretation. It becomes very difficult. Maybe there will be a term of misunderstanding. We see that handshake is not similar in all the countries. So when it is going to be effective, be ineffective if the listener is attentive. Suppose sometimes if the listener is not listening to us inattentive, the non-verbal communication will also not work. That time the verbal communication will also work. So it is seen that the gestures, the kinesics, the gesture, posture, both are very, very important, and we should use it simultaneously with non-verbal communication. We do certain things with verbal communication, but kinesics is very important.